Hi there! Welcome to a TCC Library video over reading scholarly articles for meaning. So, you have a research assignment from your professor, and you've spent a little time keyword searching in the library databases. You have a list of articles from your search. Well, what now? What's worth reading? If you find an article that looks worthwhile, what's the best way to go about reading it so that you remember and understand the important parts enough to synthesize some research into your paper? This oh-so-brief presentation covers all of this and a little more. Here are the main talking points. We will discuss how to figure out the intended audience of an article and why you might want to know that. We will discuss strategies for quickly determining what an article is about. And finally, if we determine that we have an article that we would like to synthesize into our paper, what are some good reading comprehension strategies to ensure we understand the content of an article well enough to use it? Let's start with how to figure out what the intended audience of an article is. The way I look at it, and a concept that we'll return to often, is treating an article as one half of a conversation. So the question is, who is the author trying to have a conversation with? Who does the author want to talk to? And what assumptions has the author made about the people that they are trying to reach? When it comes to audiences, there are three that we will cover today: general, academic, and trade audiences. Articles written for a general audience are written for the general public, people that come from any background you can imagine. The author will typically write for about an eighth grade level if they are writing for a general audience. Language is plain and simple, and if the author is writing about something that could be considered out of the realm of common knowledge, they will define the subject. A good example of this kind of article is something written in the National Geographic, or Nat Geo for short. If Nat Geo starts to write about something well known to archaeologists, but not to the general public, the writers take time to explain what it is that they are writing about. Next is academic audiences. These are articles where the author assumes the reader is a scholar or a researcher of some sort, often in the same field as the author. These kinds of articles are typically written at the graduate or doctorate level, and use language that reflects this sort of educational background. Often these articles are over a study of some sort, and will follow an article structure similar to that of the scientific method, with an intro, literature review section that covers what research the author did prior to their own article or study, a methodology, and a conclusion section. As far as reading comprehension is concerned, remember that academic articles tend to be wordy and make use of an extensive vocabulary. An academic author wants to be thorough and specific, so they will often take 20 words to say something that might have been said in 10 words if it was written for a general audience. These articles are more work to understand, but the trade-off is the information in academic articles is very reliable and compelling if used in your own research paper. The third kind of audience, trade, is related to academic audiences, except instead of scholars, the audience is a profession of some kind. Journal of Nursing is a good example of this. The journal is written for professional nurses. These kinds of articles will be full of professional jargon, specialized vocabulary used by a profession or a trade that is not commonly used outside of that profession, or it has a different meaning within a profession or a trade. Take the acronym RN, for example. In nursing, it stands for registered nurse, but in common online or texting slang, it means right now. The more you research, the more you get a feel for the intended audience and what to expect in terms of writing. But for the novice, there is a tool that you can use to quickly figure out what the audience is. This tool is a database called Ulrichsweb. Ulrichsweb is a database available through the TCC Library. It is located on the library's alphabetical database list under Articles and Databases from the home page. Scroll down to the Use or click on You. You may be prompted to log into MyTCC to access Ulrichsweb if you are not already logged in. You can search for a publication by name. For this video, I used Journal of Nursing as my example. Click on the title. Notice how under content type it says trade. Hopefully by now, we have a pretty good feel for the different kinds of audiences that article authors write for, and have a good idea what to expect in terms of language. Understanding article audiences can help you make a determination if an article is worth reading, or if there's one out there that's a little more accessible. Trade publications are, in my opinion, the trickiest, because some trade publications, like Journal of Nursing, are pretty technical, and other trade publications, like Nursing Today, are written in plain language. So how do you know? That brings us to the next topic, how to quickly determine if an article is worth exploring for your research. The easiest way to figure out the subject content of an article is to read the abstract, which is a short synopsis of the article. Abstracts are usually on the record page for an article, along with the title, publication, and other information. Click on the title in your search results in a database, and the abstract is usually close by. Sometimes, you have to actually look at the PDF of an article, and an abstract is at the beginning, either labeled or in a fancy blog quote. Another technique for quickly scanning an article is to use the Ctrl+F function on the keyboard to look for a keyword in a document. Open a PDF, hold down the Ctrl key, and tap the F key quickly on your keyboard to bring up a little search box and type in the word that you want to find. Then you can read the paragraph your keyword was in to skim for content. This isn't the best way to read for meaning because sometimes you can take an author's words out of context if you only zero in on a small portion of their work, but it is handy for making a judgment as to whether or not you want to read more or move on to another article. This brings us to our last topic, reading comprehension strategies. Here is how to get the most out of your reading. Practice a technique called active reading. Active reading simply means taking some kind of action while you read something. There are different levels of action you can take depending on your energy level, interest, and time constraints, with differing results. Here are some techniques you could do from most passive to most active. You could do nothing. You could just read the article from the screen. This would be passive reading, and unless you are really into the subject content or extremely motivated to read the content for some reason, it's very easy for your mind to drift or to forget the content after reading it. If you are reading from a screen, it's very easy to find yourself browsing some other tab or skimming the content as opposed to reading it for deeper meaning. We do this all the time when we read off the internet. The practice goes by several names, such as surface reading. Surface reading does just that. You skim the surface. You read the article, but you don't spend a lot of energy interacting with it or thinking about what the author has to say. I do this a lot with news articles online and social media posts. If you intend to do nothing, printing the article helps. Reading in print has proven to encourage linear reading habits, and this will keep you more focused with less distractions. Reading aloud can also be helpful. It keeps you from reading too fast and skimming the content. The second thing you could do is interact with the text a little by highlighting passages that you like. It's not much, but it's better than passive reading, and will help you remember certain key passages in an article. Watch out for over-highlighting. Many a time have I gone back into an article to look for a highlighted passage, but I couldn't remember the one that I needed. The best thing you can do is a practice called marginalia. Marginalia is the secret of the great scholars. Marginalia is a really fancy word for saying, write your thoughts in the margins of a book or an article. Treat the article not as a passive text to be read, but as a conversation that you are having with the author. And that's the trick. Reading becomes a conversation that you contribute to. Read something that makes you think. Write a comment or a question that you would pose to the author if they were listening. Like something? Comment on it. Don't like something? Pick it apart in the margins of the article. Turn reading into an active, albeit one-sided, conversation. This process will help you think about the material you're reading and avoid surface reading. You'll remember more. If you don't remember, you also have a document you can go back to and read your comments and thoughts in the margins to help you jog your memory. A similar process to marginalia is summarizing. Write your own brief abstract or summary about the article. This practice forces you to think about the subject material and make decisions as to what is most important to you. You have to condense the material, which solidifies your understanding and memory of it. The Cornell method of note-taking utilizes the summarizing process. In the Cornell method, you summarize your notes from a lecture at the bottom of a page. Let's sum up what we've covered today. We discussed the kinds of audiences an author of an article will commonly speak to: general, scholarly, and trade. We discussed two common techniques for quickly determining if an article will meet our needs: reading the abstract and using the Control-F function. Finally, we discussed reading strategies to get the most out of your time researching. Strategies include reading aloud, highlighting, utilizing marginalia, and summarizing. Thanks for watching. Feel free to like and subscribe for future content from the TCC Library.